on ZTN, which is probably Cypher's choice. And it seems like Cypher will get LG, Mega, and the YA spawn, while Rafiq will take RA.
Yep. Rafiq has Lost Cause, has got to hold back. Where has he been? Well, whatever happened to Lost Cause?
Well, he disappeared off the scene for maybe 6 months to a year. Quake 4 died out. He didn't really feel like playing Quake 3 and going back, so he didn't really play the ESWC events that have been going on the past year. But now with Quake Live back, he actually wasn't going to come to QuakeCon, but he was urged by a bunch of the U.S. players to show up and to play, and he started practicing about a few weeks ago, and now he's here.
Here we go. Nice little LG exchange there as Lost Cause finds himself low on health. Lost Cause played this one pretty smart. Didn't get the best spawn off the bat and has decided not to chase the Belarusian in the slightest. We did have them both come over here, and Cypher really wanted to be casted for this. He wanted to beat Lost Cause on stream, and that's how you do it with rails like that. Great little work from Cypher there, as he will put Lost Cause down by one frag to nil, and that nice pirouette movement on the end. So good work, good start for Cypher.
Yeah, good start for Cypher, and Rafiq is already in a lot of trouble because, I mean, Rafiq didn't get that RA. Cypher just picked up RA. Cypher has Mega Time. He even offset Mega Time by about 3 to 4 seconds, and Rafiq probably doesn't have the time now. He's just going to have to spam grenades. He's going to be able to pick up this Mega, get the lower YA, then go back to RA. And Rafiq is going to probably have to wait here, try to get this RA and defend it, but he's not going to be able to with only Plasma.
Cypher has got Rafiq very much on the back foot, off the bat. But here we go. Opportunity opens up from LG out. Good reverse rocket from Cypher there. Upwards gets it. But I think Cypher was down to at least 50 health there. He picked up the 50 bubble. I don't know what he had before then, but really excellent LG work from Lost Cause that had Cypher where he wanted him. And had not been for that reverse rocket, it could well be 1-1. And a very small window of opportunity open.
Well, Rafiq with that LG work, and LG has always been his strongest weapon in Quake 3 and Quake 4, was able to regain control of Mega. So even though he died and lost the frag there, he was able to regain control of Mega, which is probably the hardest item on this map to gain control of out of the RA and the YA. So it will be able to Rafiq, and he does get two nice rockets here, but eats a bunch of plasma, knocks the Cypher down to 11 health.
And Cypher is, though two to the good, in a spot of order. We do have the other game that's just started, Wrath of Carnage. Here we go. And we Lost Cause dropped down for the third time,
Six
and Cypher
health.
Is in control just because he knows the timing. That's the big part. Lost Cause is a little bit out of sync with the item timings, if I'm not mistaken. And that is Cypher's biggest weapon right now, because out of all of these duels, out of all of these three frags, Cypher's come out really low on health. But he's able to bide that time, pick up the item, and get himself out of there.
Two hits.
Rail comes in, does a lot of damage to Lost Cause there, down to 85. But Cypher, again, not in the best of nick. Rockets away and across. Excellent little in and out there to collect that. And Lost Cause on 10 points of health.
I mean, so Cypher with some great defensive rails there is able to RJ to that RA and able to rail Rafiq while he RJs, which was allowed him to get position on that Mega. So Rafiq had a chance to pick up the RA, pick up the Mega, regain control, but instead Cypher hits some incredible rails and then continues his control, which is going to last for another minute or two before Rafiq can get back up to speed.
6:20 left to go in this one. Score update from the other game is Carnage 1, Rafa 1 after 2. Now Cypher is going to find himself being rocketed back by Lost Cause. Lost Cause is going to land the rail onto him, but he's down to 9 points of health. And when he fell on the floor, he would have lost some more as well, but does get the Mega, so he's on full health. Rocket versus rail here in the Mega Corridor. 22 points of health for Lost Cause versus the 56 of Cypher. Both players not sure what they want to do in this situation. They know that their opponent is low on health. The question is, do they gamble and go for the frag, or do they play it safe and re-armor up, and that seems to be eventually the choice of the day.
Rafiq decided to run away there, and if he actually kept his position at RA, he would have been able to get RA, because he didn't know Cypher went around to the YA to pick up that 50 and to regain control of health before getting that RA. So Cypher, with a little bit of mind games there, got a little lucky, was able to pick up that RA and continue timing. And now has regained control of Mega, so he's going to get this RA now. He's going to have full control again for the next few minutes. Rafiq is going to have to run around and try to pick up those YAs, but Cypher even goes around to pick up the YA before the RA. So he has full control now, gets that rail, makes it 5-0. Only 5 minutes to go, and Rafiq is going to have to spend a lot of time stacking before he can even attempt the attack.
Or he's going to have to spend a lot of time dying if Cypher comes right at him with a rocket off the spawn. And that being the latter of the choices a moment ago. 6-0 the score in favor of Cypher. And Cypher is stacked up like a house of pancakes with 165-100 as he rockets himself across. And now is on the prowl for Lost Cause, who down in that mega corridor will. He's got absolutely no idea on the timing of any of the items at the moment, because Cypher has been able to dictate that play so well. There is that LG you're talking about, so powerful from Lost Cause, but it's not much against the fully armored up Cypher, who now will take yellow and I thought Mega had spawned it is up, as is red, which will be taken now. And look at that, he can afford to wait and then finish off Lost Cause. I believe that is called control.
Yeah, and he's completely cutting off Rafik at the exact moment that he has to. He knows the exact timings of all the items. He's able to offset the timings on the items if he wants to. And then he rocket jumps perfectly to where he needs to be in order to get to the next item in time. So, you know, it is really fun to see Cypher rocket jumping, like, not just for kicks, but always when he has to cut off those few seconds to gain a tactical or a height advantage on for the next item.
So, 3:30 to go. Now, the other match is about 2 minutes behind this one, so as moment this one ends, we'll switch over to the other match, which is Rafa versus Carnage. Rafa currently leading by 5-1. Lost Cause drops down, Cypher drops down, lands a rocket onto Lost Cause, who has got Mega and does have some armor. If he's going to have his, if there is an opportunity for him, it is right now to chase Cypher out, but he does not seem like he wants to take it. And you know what, he's demonstrating once again that he's not sure of the item timing. And now is his opportunity. Can he chase out Cypher, who, whilst doesn't have the Mega, this is his real chance. Lost Cause is going to drop down. Looks like he wants to go for it now. Throws himself at it. Finds Cypher. Rocket versus Rocket in the corridor. It will be Cypher to tie the shoes of Lost Cause with one of those rockets. And Lost Cause Mega is gone. Lost Cause life is gone. And this is becoming something of a Lost Cause at 9-0.
Cypher's rockets are so great. I mean, he knows exactly how Rafik is going to move. I mean, Rafik took that Mega, tried to strafe backwards, and predict that Cypher would go through to the rail, and he didn't. Instead of Cypher, just went forward and backwards and knew exactly how Rafik was going to try to dodge that. Hit some nice rockets, so Rafik getting that Mega didn't do anything. There's going to be a fight over this next Mega now, and Cypher is probably going to regain control of it. Only 2 minutes left, the score is 10-0. The map is obviously over. This is probably most likely Cypher's map pick, as the Russians do love to pick CTN. So it'll be interesting to see what Rafik is going to have for his map pick. I'm going to guess probably T4 or DM6.
Speaking of matches that may well be over, the other one is now Rafa racing into a 10-1 lead over Carnage. So this is not the most exciting round that we were expecting in this first map. In that last game of Chance Kilson was epic. And this, well, epically one-sided in favor of the Belarusian and Rafa of SK. Now, if Cypher, correct me if I'm wrong, if Cypher wins this game, he will face Avik next?
Kilson
will face Avik next.
No, Kilson will play Cypher next.
Oh, okay.
Yes. And then the winner of the winner of Rafa and Carnage will play the winner of the Hang and Griffin.
Here we go. Nice rocket landed there from Cypher once again as he bounces around the wall. He's almost like a freestyle mover as he just has absolute control of where he's going and when he's midair. Gravity is no object to him. With 45 seconds to go, this is going to end. Let's switch over to the other match just to bring you the conclusion of the first map. As we move across to Rafa versus Carnage now, and talk us through Rafa and what his preparation for this event has been.
Rafa.